What if Goku was betrayed and trapped in the time room for a millennium? Today I'm gonna tell you what it would be like if Goku were trapped in the room of time. But I'm going to add a few more things to a dialogue, bringing the beginning of the celestial war between the universes. Alright then, give this video a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any videos and stay more tuned with our stories from the Dragon Ball universe and the Z Warriors. Let's get back to the point. Universe 7. Makarite Angel appears. Goku was training on the planet Beerus, but after his training, he says he will go to the Kami-sama temple to talk to all his friends who were there. At that moment, Goku teleports straight to Earth, and at that time, Goku feels a very powerful presence. At the same time, he noticed that the existence of the planet Beerus had apparently been erased, but could not understand what was happening. At that moment, upon arriving at the temple of Kami-sama, he finds all his friends being directly imprisoned by the Makarite Angel of Universe 11. Goku transforms into a Super Saiyan and says seriously, "I know you, but what are you doing here? You are Mr. Whis's sister. Why are you attacking us? And what happened? The presence of Lord Beerus's planet is no longer being located. I can't even locate Lord Whis." Makarita says, "Well, well, you are Goku, the mortal who was able to defeat even Jiren. I thought very well before coming to Universe 7. I analyzed the powers and the most powerful beings of all the universes, and you can be one of the chosen ones to fight in the Celestial War. I just sealed the planet Beerus. I don't want my brother or the God of Destruction of Universe 7 to get involved in the matters I have to deal with. You and your other mortals, son Goku. So get ready." Goku already says, "You want to fight? So that's it. Just be aware that if you touch any of my friends, things are going to get much, much more complicated for you." At that moment, Makarite begins to smile. "After all, if I wanted to fight, I would have finished you long ago. I have powers far more cunning than my brother and many other angels. If I wanted to end you and this entire planet, I would have already done it. I just want to test it. You have only two options, accept or die alongside everyone else. What's your choice, Goku?"
Goku watches, unable to understand what is happening in that situation.
"But does he ever rage and say what you want? Well, very well. You were the one who managed to defeat Jiren. Jiren has undergone extremely powerful training, and as you may know, a heavenly war is approaching. I hear that you managed to use the Zeno Lord's powers to compete even with the Gods of Destruction. But I noticed that in Kami-sama's temple, there is a place where time passes in a different way. Then I will implement my magic power and seal it in this room of time. And you will only be able to get out of there if you manage to increase your power 1,000 times. And of course, I don't know how long this is going to take, but I do know that time in the time room runs much slower, so it might be when you get back, if you can get back. I've already finished with everyone here. What is your decision, son Goku?"
At this point, Goku can't quite understand things. Goku gets very angry about the whole situation, and he says,
"It seems that this matter of heavenly warfare is very serious. Now the angels want to test me, but that's not right. It seems that in a game of chess, we are all pawns. They mess with us the way they think is right at the moment."
Goku activates his superior instinct and teleports to the front of Makarite and tries to attack and says,
"I will not obey your orders. The angel of Universe 7 is Lord Whis, and you already pissed me off. Release my friends right now."
Makarita starts to laugh and says,
"Well, looks like I'll have to test it by force."
She creates an energy field over Goku and hurls him straight into the room of time and automatically creates a gigantic barrier covering the room of time with his angelic power. At that moment, she says,
"Well, let's see if you will make it or if you will die right there, son Goku."
At this time, Goku faints inside the time room and when he wakes up, he wonders,
"What place is this? This doesn't look like the time room. What am I going to have to do here?
Maybe if I can explode my power and raise my ki to the max, I can get out of here. It doesn't matter how many times Goku shows his strength, how much energy he tries to raise, he can't get out of there. At this moment, Goku hears the voice of the Markerite angel.
Goku, I hope you are understanding very well what your current situation and the situation of your friends. I think you better pay close attention to what you are going to do, because things will end up getting much, much more complicated. The Celestial War can start at any time, and you can stay there. If this room is destroyed, you are stuck forever until you starve to death. If you manage to get stronger and raise your power 1,000 times more, you will be able to get out of there. But how long, if you can? It looks like things are going to get much, much more complicated. I will laugh about it all, and as bad as it is, neither my brother nor Bills will be able to do anything, because until you resolve this situation, I will not unseal the planet Beerus. Good, I count on you.
Goku is enraged, but he begins to reflect and says,
So wait for me, I'm a Saiyan. I have trained and trained for many, many years. You don't know anything about me. I've been through several trainings alongside Mr. Kai, and I've trained with the Kame Master, with many, many formidable warriors. I learned to use the mastery of self-movement.
In that moment that Goku passes, all the words for Angel Markita begin, and his training begins. Days and days pass in the time room, but they were just hours in the real world. Goku was exhausted, but he kept training. Until the moment he gets to the level where the pupils of his eyes end up disappearing and the power of his superior instinct ends up getting out of control. Goku enhances his ki until the moment everything starts to explode and great temporal rifts end up being created. Markerita notes that temporal rifts appear in the real world. Goku is about to leave, but a dark presence appears beside Goku. Markerita, at the same time, is already worried and observes. So does that mean he arrived? Who did Markerita expect? It was Goku, the only one who could create this time rift after raising his powers. What's happening? To be continued. Goku raises his ki to the max. Goku's true power is shown in the time room. He has surpassed the powers of Ultra Instinct. At that moment, the angel of the universe number 11, Markerite, begins to observe and smiles. So, this is his true power. Goku is a true celestial Saiyan who managed to win the tournament of power. That's his real strength. Incredible. But it's still little. At the moment when Goku is managing to create time rifts to escape the time room where he was imprisoned by the angel of universe 11, a big explosion occurs and an unknown being emerges from one of its temporal rifts. Markerita says,
So, you finally showed up. So that was it. Goku can't understand. The moment the Saiyan showed his true strength, the time rift that was opened was for him to be able to escape the time room.
But another being appears and advances in front of him. Goku is betrayed by the angels and trapped in the time room. What matters for part 2 of Goku being betrayed by the angels and trapped in the time room? Planet Beerus. The great battle begins now. It seems like Beerus and Whis start talking.
Looks like we're stuck here on this planet, Whis. Can you believe it? While training Goku, as we taught him to reach the strongest stage of Ultra Instinct, the mastery of self-movement, we didn't notice the celestial presence of the Markerite. But after all, what is his sister planning?
Whis responds to Beerus.
Looks like she already heard about the Celestial War. There are some among angels who are betraying us. I've always had doubts between Mojito, my Universe 9 brother, and between my Universe 11 sister. I confess that I always had more doubts about Mojito. But with all this going on, I hope Markerite still has a good answer to talk about it, and now I've noticed a presence of a very powerful god of destruction who fought in the Celestial War. After she met that god of destruction from Universe 11, her behavior changed even more towards the other angels.
You mean Makarite's plan was to trap Goku in the time chamber where time paradoxes can occur,
causing him to raise his ki so much so that he could create temporal rifts and open the gate for other gods of destruction to resurface. So this was Makarite's plan.
Beerus starts to get angry and says,
"Who does she think she is? I am the god of destruction of the seventh universe. I will resolve this."
Whis starts to laugh.
"Mr. Beerus, at this moment, unfortunately, we can't do anything. We will have to believe in Lord Goku. After all, he was trained by us, and he is the only one who is in a position to fight since we are trapped inside this planet."
Back to Kami-sama's temple. The unknown presence appears in front of the Universe 11 angel. Makarita, he says,
"So you mean you're one of the gods of destruction who possessed even more powers than the angels? He still fought in the Celestial War. For now, I imagine you should be dead or sealed, and you're right here in front of me. It seems that creating time rifts can create a lot of different time paradoxes and timelines. So now you are here. Well then, what will we do?"
The unknown presence says,
"I can do what I want and destroy whoever I want, whenever I want. I don't take orders from any angel. Finally, how long did I sleep? Where was I? The only thing I know is that I lived in times of war. I was fighting a war where I was betrayed by some gods. I want revenge. I will end everything and everyone."
We have a slight chance as the unknown god of destruction talks to the Makarite angel. Goku in the time chamber. At that moment, Goku says,
"I trained for days and days, months and months, here in this time chamber. Just when I thought I would be able to escape and settle down with Makarita, this being appears in front of me. I'm getting very angry about all this going on. It's not possible. Gohan, Goten, Vegeta, Mr. Beerus, Mr. Whis, all my friends, you are trusting me. I need to help them. But now, what can I do? It seems that I have no more strength. Looks like I can't fight anymore. I need to calm down."
At that moment comes a small flashback in Goku's head. Goku starts to remember all the battles he's had and starts to see all the responsibility he has. By telepathy, Goku begins to hear Beerus's voice.
"Listen, Goku, do not be silly. You have once again surpassed your powers. You've already gotten much stronger. Sometimes, it is not possible to solve everything alone. Well, it passes what I have to say to you."
The god of destruction whispers several words to Goku. Goku starts to smile and says,
"Then that's it. Thank you, Sir Beerus."
Goku starts to smile and after hearing Beerus's words, starts to energize a spirit bomb in his body. Goku receives all the energy on the planet and all the planets from the people who know him. Beerus and Whis's energy is donated to Goku. At that moment, Goku begins to raise his powers more and more. His strength starts to get outsized and the entire time chamber starts to shake. Back outside of the time chamber, the unknown supreme god enters into an agreement with Makarite.
"So does that mean we have something in common?"
"It means we want to end Zeno-sama."
"Then that's it."
"Everything that has to happen will be very interesting."
"The real battle will start now, since we have no angels and no gods of destruction now in Universe number 7. It looks like I am going to start destroying this entire universe."
The moment Makarite begins to laugh alongside the unknown supreme god, a big explosion happens in the time chamber. Goku activates the second stage of Ultra Instinct after receiving energy from the Angel, the God of Destruction, and all mortals in Universe 7. Goku says,
"Margarita and you don't know, but I am already irritated. You managed to infuriate me too much and still want to attack my friends. Now you pay for it."
Kami-sama Temple. After several events, the Markarite Angel of Universe 11 is still fascinated with the demonstration of powers that Goku can do.
"You mean that even without the God of Destruction and even without Whis, you still tend to exceed your limits, Goku? This Spirit Bomb technique is extremely interesting. Good strategy. Since you're alone, you managed to ask for powers from Beerus and Whis so that they could give you their strength and you would reach a new level of transformation, the second level of higher instinct. Interesting. But maybe that's not enough for you to defeat me. In fact, to defeat me, you will need to fight the God of Destruction of the universe erased by Zeno-sama."
At this time, the unknown God of Destruction says,
"So that's the power of a Saiyan. It means that, in addition to getting stronger, you trained in a room of time, where time passes in a totally different way. Well, I must thank you that thanks to you, the time paradox was created. I am free. I still have many things to do here. I have no time to waste with you."
Good. Let the games begin now. What if Goku was betrayed by the angels and imprisoned in the Room of Time for millennia? Part 3. The Time Room. Goku at this moment activates his new transformation after receiving the power of the Spirit Bomb and absorbing the energy of Beerus and Whis, who were once trapped inside the planet Beerus by a Markarite trap, which the sister gave to Universe 11 Whis. At that moment, Goku says,
"It seems that Mr. Beerus is very smart. Even though he was far away, he managed to come up with this plan that would allow me to fight these monstrous gods of destruction directly. I can't let my friends die. I know I have the power I need to be able to finish anyone off. Well, I think I know what to do."
At that moment, a large sphere of energy is created, and in that moment, a new time rift opens, where Goku manages to escape the Room of Time. And at that time, Goku already says,
"Now you pay me. Our battle begins now, Margarita, and you, unknown being. Now, I will finish you."
At that moment, when Goku goes to attack the Markarite Angel, the unknown being appears in front of him and says,
"You shouldn't attack an angel before a God of Destruction, and especially when that angel is a woman."
At that moment, Goku is stopped and thrown far away from Kami-sama's temple, and Goku says,
"This can only be a joke. Even knowing the power of a God of Destruction, I'm sure this guy is on a whole different level. I'm sure this guy is no ordinary god. Even Sir Beerus being very powerful, it seems this guy's strength is similar to Mr. Whis's, or even greater. What's happening?"
Goku energizes the power of the Spirit Bomb again in his body and starts trying to unleash several attacks. At that moment, Margarita starts to laugh and says,
"It seems that the power a Saiyan can reach is incredible. But would a Saiyan be more powerful than a god that even the angels fear? The power of destruction is incredible, depending on the user who performs the technique. Only with the Hakai it is possible to end the planet. But already other beings, in fact, they don't use Hakai. They just swallow these planets. That would be something totally surreal. And apparently, this God of Destruction manages to do that."
Margarita starts laughing and says,
"What are you going to do with that, son Goku?"
planet Beerus. Beerus starts analyzing everything and says,
"It seems we got it wrong, and we got it wrong a lot, Whis. I still can't believe this is happening. Do you mean to say that this was the true plan of the Markarite, ending and directly erasing Universe 7? But after all, just out of pure ego, or to create a new celestial revolution? This fight is between angels. We could never imagine that an angel would want to end everything. After all, you are the ones who must bring protection to the universes. It makes no sense."
At this point, Whis tries to analyze, and he says,
"Maybe that could be it. Or indeed, that being might not be the Markarite. I have a suspicion that she is being manipulated by someone. Or the one we are seeing isn't the real Markarite. I find it very difficult for this god of destruction to be more powerful than my sister from Universe 11. Something wrong is happening. We'll still find out."
Beerus rages.
"I'm trying to understand what's going on. We don't have much time for that. I already had one more plan, and I already know what we should do."
At this time, Goku continues to fight against the being of celestial destruction that possesses the powers of the level of a god of destruction. The battle starts to get more and more insane. Goku receives several and several blows, even with his new transformation. Goku doesn't know what to do. Although, at this moment, Goku further raises the power of Higher Instinct Phase 2. And I heard by telepathy again, Beerus's voice saying,
"Goku, I have an idea, and listen carefully. This will have to be very fast."
At that moment, Goku, while fighting against the unknown being of destruction, hears Beerus's words. Beerus whispers to Goku. At that moment, Goku starts to smile, saying,
"I get it."
And that's when Goku starts to raise his ki to the maximum. Margarita starts to laugh, and at that time, Goku teleports to land a great dragon attacked directly on the god of destruction, Renegade. Margarita keeps laughing, saying,
"This can only be a joke. You've seen over and over and over again that this wouldn't work. So what do you think about doing now?"
At that moment, Goku, when he is about to land the dragon's blow on the god of destruction, teleports himself and appears behind the Brandite. But Margarita for a second let her guard down. But with the power of self-movement mastery, he dodges Goku and says,
"Did you believe that with that you would be able to hit me? You must be kidding. How dare you? I'm an angel. Would never be defeated by that."
At that time, Goku attacks the renegade god of destruction again and holds his body, grabbing him without wanting to release him. The god of destruction says,
"You're crazy. I will finish and swallow your existence now. You want to die right here, Goku."
At that moment, the smile starts and teleports again to the time room. And he starts creating different time rifts. At this time, Goku is once again given the powers of Beerus and Whis. At that moment, after Goku receives all his power, he manages by a strategy to use the teleportation going to another celestial universe, leaving the god of destruction of the renegade universe behind, after teleporting again to the room of time and closing the temporal rift. The renegade god of destruction says,
"I can't believe this is happening. So that was your strategy. Even though you knew you'd never have more power to fight me, you were still smart enough to send me somewhere else." "Formidable, Goku. But know that I will be back."
At that moment, Goku is still trapped in the room of time.
"It feels like now I'm out of energy. My body is exhausted. I won't be able to go back. At least not yet. Looks like I'm going to need to recover my energies so I can create new temporal rifts. But And now? I'm sorry, Mr. Beerus. I'm sorry, Whis. I haven't been able to save them all.
Margarita starts to laugh and says this.
Amazing, Goku. But now I'm without the god of destruction I need. I'll finish you guys myself.
At that moment, Beerus and Whis teleport to the time room. Margarita says,
How did you manage to get here?
Whis starts laughing and says,
Good. The moment Goku tried to land the dragon attack on you, you let your guard down and ended up undoing the sealing effect of planet Beerus. You didn't even notice. When she got mad at Goku, we ended up letting go. Well, what do you have to say about all this, sister?
At that moment, Margarita starts to laugh in a totally insane way and says,
I think it's better this matter stays just between us. After all, you wouldn't want to involve the High Priest above all that. At some point, I will still come back. So wait for me, brother.
At that moment, Beerus observes and says,
What will you do about it?
And Whis talks.
This will stay between us. I still have business to discuss with her.
Good. So it looks like the problem is solved.
At this moment, Beerus says,
We still have Goku. He is now trapped in the Room of Time.
Whis telepathically talks to Goku and says,
We solved everything around here, at least so far. Would you like me to get you out of there?
At that moment, Goku starts to smile.
I am very happy that you have already resolved this situation, Mr. Beerus and Mr. Whis. But now I have discovered a new training phase where I can raise a higher instinct higher and higher. So for a moment, I'd rather you leave me here. I swear, I'll leave here another being, and I will become stronger and stronger.
Empty Galaxy. Margarita and Mojito hold a meeting. Margarita says,
As expected, brother, Goku's potential is extremely high. I will warn Belmont in Universe 11. Now the real plan begins.
To be continued. Alright, partner, what do you believe? And what do you think about all of this? What is Goku's power level? To what extent will he continue training in the time room? A grand strategy to fight a god of destruction from an unknown universe. A great battle may still take place in the future, as the unknown god of destruction has said that he will return. Regardless of what it is, it's more than important that you come out here in your comments so that we can get into that crazy debate. If you enjoyed the video, whack that like button and consider subscribing to the channel so that you don't miss any future videos. That's all there is to it. And I will catch you in the next video. Goodbye.